Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? I am on my way up to the shop with the Kramer and the bigger Zeta. The New Holland is still working away on the cornfield, although it's nearly finished, so it won't be too long before we go up there and just empty it out for the last time and dump a little bit more grain in for the pigs and see how we're doing with that. The Kirovitz is still over there at our new fields waiting to start the ploughing, but I thought that I would actually do the tree planting first before I start work with the Kirovitz. And so we can get the tree planting done, and that way I'm hoping that it will have grown before we finish the series, because I am aware that it takes quite a little while for the trees to actually grow, which is why I thought I would come up here first. So what I'm going to do is we're going to buy 2 pallets of trees, because you get 20 for each one. So let's just hop out of here and run into the store. There we go, in through the doors. Right. What we want first is forestry equipment, and we want to lease this one here, the tree planter. Select and lease. Yes. As it's just a one-off use and we won't be using it again after this. And then pallets, I'm going to get... See, it's 20 trees, so we'll plant 20 trees if we do this. Actually, I think we'll do 3. We'll get 3 pallets. Takes a little while to use up 3 pallets, but we can do that. And we'll load one of them up on the... tree planter itself, and we'll carry 2 with the Kirovitz. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to buy a pallet fork, because we've got a bale spike down at the yard, but we don't own a pallet fork, so I'll buy one of those, because we could very well be using that again when we come to with our full numbers of pigs. We could very well end up with needing to buy pallets of pig food, so that could be quite handy. Helper J has completed their task. That means that the combine is finished. So I'm going to quickly run over there to where the combine is. But before I do that, my weekly question. I originally said that we would be buying a square baler. And it was going to be, if I can find it, this one right here, the New Holland Big Baler 340 in the red and yellow livery. However, the Kuhn DLC is coming out next week, and... in it is a square baler. It's a different... it looks different to this. It's, you know, a lot of the balers that I've seen so far are just reskins of this baler. This itself is a reskin of the standard vanilla game one. But the Kuhn one looks completely different. It's still... the end product is still the same, but I just thought I'd give you the chance to do something a little bit different with the baler. So do you want me to stick with our original plan of the New Holland, or do you want me to go for the Kuhn baler? It's your choice. It's your vote, rather. It's your game. Head in the comment section down below, let us know what you want, and of course don't forget to actually vote by mousing over in the top right hand corner up here. I am going to, we'll just leave these here a minute and we'll sort that out in just a moment. I'm going to run up to the cattle first. I think I might stop at the chickens as well on our way up here, and we can gather up all of our eggs. We've got loads of eggs here, and I'm not quite sure how many I'm carrying at the moment. Several. And we did sell some eggs, but I think we might actually go and sell some more fairly soon, because we do have an awful lot here. I'll gather them all up, and then I will meet you over at the combine, and we can see how many eggs we've got and how much corn we've got as well. That's going to be quite important. Just got one last little line up through here. I don't know if the hired help would actually do it for me or not. I might. Looks like it. Yeah, one last little line. We got 4,800 litres of grain in there. And if you have a look in here, we got 167 eggs in our backpack. So those 167 eggs, you know, I can't remember how much we actually get for eggs. And it doesn't separate them out on here either. So I don't really know about that. Trees planted. We've cut down 40 trees. I had no idea we cut down that many trees. But anyway, trees planted. We'll be doing that today. And hopefully we'll get that number up to the full 60 that we are expecting. And if you have a look in the top right hand corner at the moment, you'll see that we are actually scheduled for rain fairly soon. I'm guessing that rain will be tomorrow morning. So at least we've finished our harvest and we'll get the planting done. I think that it's likely that we'll end up... hang on, let me just... we won't be doing our planting... today, so we will have to delay our planting in order to be able to do it during dry weather. That's not really much of an issue. We certainly don't want to be doing too much cultivating and stuff like that in dry weather. Right, I'll empty this one out, and then I will take it over to the pigs, and we can dump it in there and see how much we can fill that up with. Okay, we'll come up here, and we'll tip this out. I'm just going to stop that robot there a minute. If I can jump into him quickly. There we go. And I was just thinking it'd be really cool if we could dig a road right through there, in direct line to the pigs. And it reminded me, I did read on one of the forums recently, I can't remember which one it was, but what they said was, one, two, I think it's two, I might have to go three. Tip side back, yeah. Sorry, I was just trying to figure out which side I wanted to tip this one on. After all that, I'm tipping at the back one anyway. Hopefully that's tipping into the pigs. Yes, it is. It's tipped into the pigs. So why is that one done different? You know, sometimes this thing confuses me. Giants were apparently trying to figure out a way to do deformable, reformable terrain so that you could basically dig up the terrain and move the stuff round, and it stay like it after you've done the digging. Right, corn is now 25,000 litres, and it looks to be about two-thirds full. We're going to need a lot more corn. A lot more corn. We are definitely going to be planting our next, the big field, with corn again, and we're going to have to do corn every single harvest in order to just hopefully try to keep up just a little bit. Anyway, I'll take this one back to the main yard. I'll come back and get the combine another time. Actually, no, I'm just going to put this one over here for now, and then I'll ferry them back later on. Right now, we want to do our tree planting. And then I can continue talking to you about the plans that giants have now, and so on. But I think it's mostly rumours. Right, we'll hitch on the tree planter, and we'll load one of those pallets onto here, and then we'll carry the other two on the Kramer. Giants, they are currently working on this reformable terrain so that you would be able to dig stuff up and move it round, and it'd stay like it, and it sort of become, you know, it's like permanent deformable stuff, which sounds really, really cool. I'm really looking forward to seeing this. They weren't happy with it. They didn't think that it was up to par at the moment, which is why it wasn't released with this game. But they are apparently hoping to release it with FS19. Now, I have no idea whether this is true or not, and what the sources are for this information. It might just be wild speculation. However, we do know that Cattle and Crops, the other big farming simulator game that is currently in development, that one, they do already have it implemented. But how well Cattle and Crops is going to play out, I don't yet know. I do have it pre-ordered, and I will hopefully be able to do videos of it once it's released. I'm quite looking forward to being able to do that for you all. And depending on how well it goes, we may even move to 3 Cattle and Crops episodes a week and 3 Farming Simulator episodes a week. At the moment, I really don't know. I couldn't tell you either way what we're going to be moving to. It'll sort of depend how Cattle and Crops is, what it's like, and what everybody thinks of it. Because, this is really what I do on this channel is down to everybody that watches. So, I won't be rushing into anything too quickly. To start with, we'll just do a few episodes here and there of Cattle and Crops just to see how it pans out. Right, I can carry these two like this if I go reasonably steady. And I will get that tractor on follow me as well. And then we'll make our way over to the area that we prepared. We cut down all those trees and removed all the stumps and everything else. So then we can start planting some trees. We've got 60 trees now that we're going to plant. So let me just put that on follow me. There we go. And hop into here. Right. Is he following? Yep. There he goes. So we will now head down to where we're going to be planting, next to the sawmill, and see about getting started with our planting. Huh. You know, I thought that I came through and I removed the stumps. It would appear that I didn't remove any stumps. I wonder why ever I did that then. I could have sworn that I was... I know I was planning to come back and remove the stumps. Well, it would appear that I haven't removed any of the stumps. So, well, we're still, I'm not changing my plans. We're still going to be doing this. But what I will do is I'll just plant round the tree stumps. So let's just take this off a follow. There we go. And we'll bring this one. Let's go up to the top first, and we'll do some lines down next to the road. Now, when you bring up the options for this, you've got turn on tree planter, hire worker, lower tree planter, toggle map size, and allow create fields. Now, I think, because I was using it with GPS when I've been using a bit in the time lapse, which you'll see on Sunday, where I was using it. But what I don't think you actually need to have allow create fields turned on. I think you can do it without it. I'm not going to use the GPS this time. I'm going to use this just, we're just going to drive by hand. So what you do is if you have a look here, we'll sort of zoom in a little bit. You can see the way that they've got a rotary thing on there. And if I start it up, that one starts digging. Basically what it does, it just digs a big hole there and you can see the blades. It pushes the earth to the side. You would have a person standing on there and they drop the tree down into the trench that is formed. And then those red blades at the back, they push the earth back over it and cover it back over again. So I don't know. I think we can do this without having the allow create fields option on. So I've got it turned on and it's lowered. So if I just start, yeah, it started playing. So you don't even need to do the allow create fields. It's quite, it can be quite difficult to see the tree. There you go. See, it does come out. So I'll come down a little bit further. There, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hop off so that we can take a look at it. See it spinning there, and then you can just see, make out the tree here a little bit. Clouds have started to come in. I think it is going to start raining fairly soon. But anyway, there is our tree planter and our trees. Let's get going. The time we get down to the bottom, it's quite slow. We do 5 kilometers an hour on this one, so don't expect record-breaking speeds. But what I thought is if we just do one line down here, and then we'll move over a bit and we'll do another line coming back up. And if you keep the trees in reasonably straight lines, what you find is after, or when you come to cut them down later on, you can sort of set the Scorpion King, the Ponzi, into like one position and just drive in a line. You grab the tree, cut it, let it go, and then move forward a bit, grab the next tree, cut it. At least that's what I'm hoping that we can do. So that's why we need to keep these rows reasonably straight. I mean, it doesn't matter if we move a little bit. We can allow a little bit of movement on it. So we'll use up this crate. And once we get down to the... I've actually turned a little bit, haven't I? Doing great at keeping a straight line. I was supposed to be running parallel with the road the entire way, but that's not quite worked out. Come right down here. I don't mind it going right down to the edge. It's all of this grass area we're going to be using for, because I did originally think that we could use this for another area for mowing, but quite frankly, we've got plenty of grass. We don't need to worry about getting more. So we'll just keep using this. And I'm curious how long it takes for the trees to go from this stage to the next stage, because the stage that the trees are at right now, is it going to plant one? There we go. That's as far as we want to go with that. So I lift it. I've been turning it off when I turn round. But the trees at this stage, you can drive through them. Okay? You have a look at the tree there. Look, see, I can drive over it. It doesn't stop me. It doesn't do anything. The tree's there, and the game will register that the tree is there. It's just that it won't... what's the word I'm looking for? It won't stop you. It's not got any collision on it yet. And I'm assuming that the next growth stage of the tree will put the collision onto it. So, just start it up. I'm not sure how quickly the next tree will come out. And whether it's dead even, if it's... Yeah, so that's fairly well in line, that is. So if we just keep going up this line here, we've got 4 trees left on board our pallet. There's one of them. And I'm going to change over. As soon as I've used up this pallet, I'll bring up another one, then I will go and plant that, because you've seen this thing happening now. You don't really need to sit here and watch this entire process, because it could get a little bit dull. So what I've been doing is, rather than stopping the, you know, most of the time, rather, I've been leaving the tractor like that and then going and getting the loader and bringing the next pallet over. The one thing that I don't like about it is that you have to use whole pallets. What you can't do is go up to, you know, when you get to the end of the row, you can't lift up, go over to the pallets and take part of a pallet so that you top up the one that you've got. You've got to use up the whole pallet, and then after you've used up the whole pallet, then you can come and refill the next one. So you've got to keep sort of stopping on part rows. I'm just going to leave it like that. I'm not going to bother trying to take them off the forks. And if I just press R, it'll load it up like that, and then we can carry right on. It's still running, still operational. So I will carry on up here. I'll use up this next pallet, and then we can reload the machine again to use the final pallet. And then I think we're actually going to have to go and go home for the night, and we'll start the ploughing on our field first thing in the morning. This next pallet hasn't lined up with the last one, so we've not got dead straight rows of trees. I have found that they don't seem to line up very often, to be honest. I was trying it from in-cab, and I gotta say, I think this would be a horribly dull, slow job to do in real life. To actually sit here and nurse this planter through. Yeah, I think that would be painfully dull to have to do. It's not something I've ever done. I've never really been involved with any forestry work. I've used a chainsaw a little bit, on and off, but that's about as much as my forestry experience goes. I've certainly never used anything like this before. I have seen them being used at a distance, but I've never been involved with them in any way, shape, or form. Now, I'm not going to try and plant through a tree stump. I'm going to put another line a little bit further over this time. And I'll come down here because I've got two tree stumps to avoid there. So there's one planted already. I can imagine what this job would be like. I have had to plant a few trees by hand before now, and that's not the most thrilling of experiences either. So yeah, it's something I don't mind doing in game, I've found. Just a little bit. I wouldn't want to do lots of it. Quite frankly, I'm not particularly looking forward to planting the poplars on field one in Goldcrest Valley anymore because of just how painfully slow this thing is. And I imagine it'd be much the same with the poplars. I can't imagine it would be going any faster with those. So it's not something I'm looking forward to. But it's something that we'll do. We'll get it done. I'll make an episode or so out of it, and then I will finish it off in my own time, and then it'll be done and out of the way. So don't expect loads and loads of poplars through FS17. It's probably not something I'm going to do a lot of unless I can, you know, really rely on the hired help to just carry on with it while I go off and do other things. We'll have to see about that. It's whether you can load up more pallets on here than just the one. It's having just one pallet, I think, is going to slow down the process quite a bit. But anyway, I will just finish off this pallet now, and then we can... I think we'll have to go home for the night. Two left, and that'll be it. Trees are finally planted. There's 60 trees that we've stuck in here, which is not bad going, really. I think that's reasonably impressive, all things considered. Let's just take a look at the statistics and see if that is fully reflecting that. Where are we? Yes, 60 trees planted. Not bad going. So those trees we will chop down at some point when they're fully grown. I'm not quite sure when that'll be. At the moment, we've got 134 pigs, and they're on 1 hour and 7 for each new pig. So, yeah, we'll see what that's like. I'm going to take this one and return it to the shop, and I'm going to take both of these machines back down to our yard, and then I'll also bring the new Holland and the Belarus back as well. I will go home for the night, and then in the morning, we can get started on our ploughing with the Kirovits and start turning those two fields over there into one field over there. Well, I had a good night's sleep. The Kirovits is here, ready to roll, but it's hoofing it down with rain. So, yeah, it does look like we are going to have to wait until a bit later on. Although, I did want to try this out just once, because we got the ground response, and normally I get hail, I don't get rain. So I would like to just try one pass up across the fields. We're going to use the GPS on this. I want to keep it nice and straight so I don't have to have the roller going up the edges, if I can... if I can do that. So I want to automate the working width like that. That's taking it to 3.6 meters. And if we just double check with our plow, that one is a 3 meter working width. So I am going to reduce that down to a 3 meter width. Let's come down like that so that we don't get any missing space. I don't want anything missing at all. The offset, I think, is it looks about right. So if I just move this one over a little bit like that, maybe not quite so much. Yeah, we'll have a bit of overlap into the field at the moment like that. Line that up. I'm going to keep the lines showing. That's all we need to do for now, I think. So let's put it like that. Oh, no, hang on. There's one other thing that we do need to do. Bring that one back up. I want to have that one there selected. That automatic offset reversal. So when we turn round, the offset will reverse as well. So I need to press Y to allow create fields. Lower it down like that. And we're away. It should line up itself and start doing it. Now, in theory, the wheels should slip a little bit with the rain that's coming down. You should get more mud, and you should get a bit of slipping and so on. I don't know if it's just on this, or if it's on whether other tractors would do it more than this Kurovitz would. Well, I think what we'll do is we'll just do this one pass up across the field so that we can see what it's like. And then we'll go and get the Zeta, the bigger Zeta, and we'll drive that one in the field a bit just to see if the wheel slipping thing is going to happen. I'm not really sure if it is. Doesn't look like it's thinking of slipping very much. We got it a little bit here, I suppose. Yeah, I really don't know. I thought it was that was part of the ground response thing. It was supposed to slip when it was muddy. Unless that's something that's in the script, but it's not actually available because we're not the map hasn't been prepared for it. I'm not quite sure. I think you got a little bit of slipping. I don't know about that. Now up this end, what I'll do is I will bring the roller up here and we'll tidy this up a bit because it's a bigger plow. We'll do one line along there and then we'll use the roller to sort of tidy it up. So if I lift that one and turn it, I see that it is, you know, the machine is trying to turn itself to that particular line. So I've come over here and yeah, the offset has now reversed itself. But we'll worry about that later. I'm going to go over and find a Zeta. I know I don't normally like to do this, but I am just going to very quickly tab over. I normally like to walk over. What I want to do is I just want to see if it's going to do any wheel slipping in the field here. Now that we've got nothing planted, we can sort of have a little bit of a whiz around. I'll hitch on the water tanker and just test it out a bit here. Is this what it's supposed to? I did read somewhere that it is supposed to slip and make more mud. It does look like it's making more mud than normal. Slow down. Start. I think it's slipping a bit, and it does look like it's throwing more mud than it would normally. It's a job to tell. It really is a job to tell. If it is doing it, it's kind of a very subtle effect that you don't notice very much. So I don't really know either way. Anyway, I'm going to wait until the weather clears up a bit, and then I'm going to carry on with our ploughing down the end until the end of the episode. It stopped raining at last. It's been hoofing it down for hours. It's all morning it's been raining. What a wasted half a day. But anyway, we now have 150 pigs and we're getting a new pig every hour. So this time tomorrow we'll have 175. Well, actually it'll be more than that because that will continue to reduce. We'll have another cow by tomorrow as well. Although, at the moment, the milk that we're getting from the cows is not offsetting all of our costs because you do get daily maintenance costs for animals. But once we get another 250 pigs, which won't take very long at all, we will be able to start really raking in some cash. I'm creeping forward here at the moment. I'm not quite sure why, because I don't think my pedals are pushing forward. There must be something. No! Oh! Yeah, well, you know what I did there, don't you? I put it going, but I didn't actually engage the GPS, so let's just lower that down. Engage GPS, and go again. Right, it will wiggle the plough a little bit around while it straightens up, but it's now straightened up just nicely. Yeah, see, we don't get quite so much mud coming up off the tyres now that it's not raining anymore. So it does do something. I do prefer to work when it's not raining and cloudy and misty and everything, because it really does affect your visibility quite badly, doesn't it? And so anyway, what I'm going to do is I'm going to work up and down here. I'm going to go right out to the edge of the path there, up against those trees. I won't go very much up that way. Then we'll do a line, maybe two lines over that side of the field. And finally, we can finish out the bit in the middle. And then once I've done that, I think I'll try to work the fields themselves. Although, given what we know about the hired help at the moment, it might be better if I work those two fields before I do the top and bottom of them, because otherwise the machine's not going to want to stop. There seems to be a bit of an issue at the moment. I mean, they are going to be patching it very soon. They have said that there is a patch on the way, 1.4.2, that is going to fix these issues. Now, I'm deliberately coming out onto the track here, and it's I'll go over it with the roller, because this plow is quite a bit bigger. And I mean, like the Jimper ones, they're quite easy to work with because they're like an easy set shape. They're like almost like a round footprint on the ground. These, however, they're not. They're a very classic V type shape that you get. So one thing it doesn't seem to like is the articulated steering. It seems to screw with it ever so slightly. Right, let's drop that one down there. It is working, it's okay. So we'll let that one carry on. Once it's going in a straight line, it's fine, but going backwards and forwards, the GPS system seems to want to make it wiggle backwards and forwards an awful lot. So I don't know what it would be like using this one to turn on the headland, using the GPS to turn on the headland. And I might end up having to do that with ploughing this field. I'm not quite sure yet. Depends if it can still recognise where the end of the field is using the GPS. It's actually something that we could find out in a minute. We are getting close to the end of this episode, so what I'll do is I will finish ploughing all of this before next week, because now that we've seen a bit of ploughing, we don't need to see a load more. We've done the tree planting, we're doing this. I'm hoping by next week it will have been patched. The issue with the hired help will have been patched, so we won't have to worry about that anymore. And so I'll get these two fields ploughed as well. One thing I wanted to look at a minute, if I just escape out of here, I'll come back this way, fruit types, growth, soil composition. I think I actually ploughed them just before I bought them. So, you know what, we won't worry about ploughing up fields. I don't think that we need to worry about that. And then when the fields are ready to be ploughed, we'll just plough this outside edge bit as well, and do the whole lot all at once. So it just mean that it get ploughed a little bit early rather than doing the bigger field. So we end up doing more ploughing than we need to on a smaller area of land. That's my theory behind all of this. Let's turn round, flip the plough over. I think two more passes up this side will have us done. But I'm getting quite close to the end of the series. Let's go over this side, and if I go belting up through here like this, we'll do one pass down this side of the field. Here we go. Right, that one's too far over, so I am going to have to do this one here. But it's going to be turning it the wrong way, isn't it? So we need to have it out this end. So that one there, and then that one there. I think we'll go down here. I think if I go any further than that, it's going to end up causing us issues down the other end, isn't it? You know what? Let's live life dangerously. Let's do another width out here, like this. And if I engage GPS now, I'll go up like that. See the way that it's wiggling. It does mess with it a little bit, doesn't it? Right, let's try and straighten up. There we go. I'll lower it down there. I know it's a fair way back, but I think it will be all right. Now let's see if I've misjudged this, because it is further down, whether we got too much of a steep bank on the side. Because if there's too much of a bank on the side, what it does is the combines get over it and then it lifts them up into the air. It kind of levers them up into the air because they can't reach it all. And that gets quite interesting. Hopefully it won't do that and it will just run through okay. At the moment, no, we can't put another one. You see where the bank is just sort of starting there? I think we are pushing the limit of where we can go before it starts to detrimentally affect the performance of the combine, and we don't want to do that. So anyway, my question for this week, we are planning to get a square baler. And everybody said that you want me to get the New Holland square baler in the red and yellow livery, the one that is typically used for the US and not for Europe. But we said that we'd use that one anyway. But we've got the Kuhn DLC coming out next week, and they have a completely new square baler. Looks quite a bit different to the others. It doesn't produce anything different, it just looks different, and I thought it looked pretty cool. So do you want me to use that one instead of our originally planned New Holland baler? It's your vote, it's your game. Head in the comment section down below, let us know what you think. And of course, don't forget to actually cast your vote by mousing over in the top right-hand corner to see the poll up there and cast your vote. Now, if I just spin this one around, yeah, I think that we've got that about right down that side. I don't think we'd want to go any further than that. Now, if I can line this up, I've got to remember I need to line it up with the blue line, not with the green line. Get it lined up reasonably right. Come forward a bit so that I'm on the road. There. And carry on up across the field here. So I think I'm going to need to do two more passes on this side. Then I can finish it over there on that track over there. And then, like I said, I'll do out that piece in the middle. I'm not going to bother ploughing the field itself. And we're going to want to plant corn here, so I will need to cultivate the bit in the middle. I'll probably end up just cultivating all of it anyway, because, as you know, the game will allow us to plant after ploughing, but in real life you can't do that. You have to cultivate first. So we'll probably cultivate the whole field, ploughed land as well as non-ploughed land, and I'm hoping that hired help will actually be able to cope with that bit. Well, we'll see. That's something for next week, that is. So, I really have, I think, run out of time now. If you've enjoyed this episode, then please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. Today's topic of conversation, which I did actually completely forget about, is the hired help. What do you think of the hired help in its current state? And do you think it would be really cool if Giants were to bring something like the auto combine mod that we used to have in FS15 as part of, you know, something like that as sort of part of the standard game? What would you think of that? So that is a topic of conversation. I completely forgot about mentioning it earlier. That's why I'm bringing it up as late as I am, but there we go. So talk about that in the comment section. I'd love to hear your views on it, what you think you'd like to see from Giants regarding the AI helper, what you think that they ought to be able to do and not be able to do and so on, and what improvements you'd like to see in it. It's a particularly hot topic of conversation this week, I feel, because of the issues we've had with the 1.4 patch. But anyway, I look forward to reading your comments. I will discuss if I have time, obviously. If I don't, don't worry, I do still read them. I do still pay attention to what you say if you're making suggestions for what you want me to do in the series, etc., etc. That is all I've got time for. So thank you very much for watching. I'm sure there was something else that I was going to say then. I got completely distracted then because I thought there was something really important I needed to say before I finish up the series. The episode. This is not the end of the series. Fear not. This is not the end of the series. This is just the end of the episode. It's completely slipped my mind. My mind's gone completely blank now. So anyway. Until next time. Thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye and see you later.